Hello guys, so in this video we will be studying about the structure of neuron, that which parts the neuron consist of. Before studying the structure of neuron, we must know that the neuron consists of the three main parts: the cell body, the axon. This is called as the cell body. This is the axon. This part is called as the axon terminal. So now, first we will come towards the cell body of the neuron. The cell body, or the soma, or the perikaryon, it consists of various structures within the neuron which perform various functions. Now I will label some of the important parts of the neuron. First of all, the membrane which surrounds the neuron is called as the plasma membrane. The main director of the cell, known as the nucleus. It consists of the smaller structure within it, the nucleolus, where the rRNA synthesis usually takes place. The structure formed inside the nucleus comes out from the nucleus from this part known as the nuclear pore. The cytoplasm of the neuron . It consists of various organelles, just like this is the mitochondria. These are small aggregations of rough endoplasmic reticulum known as the Nissl's granules. These are long structures known as the neurofilaments. These are usually named generally as microfilaments, but as we are studying the structure of neuron, so these are known as the neurofilaments. It consists of various other organelles, just like the Golgi apparatus. I hope that you might be knowing the function of all these organelles. The organelles which are new in this structure, I will explain about that. Just like Nissl's granules, these are long aggregations of rough endoplasmic reticulum, which are important in protein synthesis so that enzymes can be made, those enzymes which are required in the synthesis of neurotransmitters, just like acetylcholine, etc. Now coming on to the next structures, this rounded structure, this is called as the lysosome. Now these elongated structures which are projecting out of the cell body, these are called as the dendrites. Whereas a little elevation in this dendrite is called as the dendritic spine. Later on we will study that this dendritic spine is helpful in making of the synapse. Dendritic spine. However, also you can see some of these granules which are present in the cytoplasm. These are small ribosomes which are used for mRNA synthesis. Small various structures are also found in this structure of the neuron. Now coming on to this part, this elevated small portion of the neuron, which is just like a neck to the neuron, this is called as the axon hillock. Axon hillock. This is the part of the axon, or this is the part of the neuron where the action potential is generated. Action potential is generated. Let me tell you, just like suppose these neurons may also act as receptors. Suppose someone has pinched you here, information from this part usually get transferred to the dendrite. Dendrite receives it, transfers it to the cell body. As soon as the nerve impulse reaches the axon hillock, the action potential is generated here. The running action potential is called as the nerve signal reaches here to the axon hillock, action potential is created, and this action potential is carried throughout the length of the neuron in the form of a nerve impulse. So what is a nerve impulse? Transfer of action potential along a nerve fiber is called as a nerve impulse. Now talking about the axon, what structures are present in the axon? Axon is a long structure starting from the axon hillock and ending up to the axon terminal. You can see these structures. This is the structure which is called as the myelin sheath. This small cell is called as the Schwann cell. This small area in between the two myelin sheaths is called as the node of Ranvier. This node is present so that the transfer of the impulse can take place in a very fast way, which is also known as the saltate reconduction, as it helps in quick transfer of the nerve impulse and also saves the lot of energy. Now coming on to the final part of the neuron, it is called as the axon terminal. As here, small axon terminal usually consists of small portions called as the synaptic knobs. Just I have said you that, let me show you here. Suppose this is a dendritic spine. This dendritic spine usually comes in contact with the end of the axon, which usually consists of a knob. Neurotransmitter releases takes place and one information from one neuron to another neuron takes place, which is called as the synapse. So this was the structure of the neuron. Now let me tell you some important facts about this. As these microfilaments and microtubule structures, which I have explained you here, these together are known as the neurofibrils. Moreover, as you might have seen that the cell usually consists of a structure called as the centriole, which mainly helps in the division of the cell. In case of a neuron, there is also the presence of a centriole, but that centriole is not used for division, but that centriole is used for the maintenance of these neurofilaments and the neurotubules. Means the centriole present in the neuron is mainly used for the maintenance of the neurofibrils as well as the neurotubules. Now as I have explained you about the dendrites, dendrites usually consist of short tapering ends so that these can receive the information from the corresponding neuron. This is the axon hillock, and moreover the cytoplasm of the axon is called as the exoplasm, whereas the membrane surrounding the axon is called as the axolemma. Now I want to tell you a little bit about the axonal transport, that how the transport along the axon usually takes place. So axonal transport means that how the transport through the axon takes place. Either it may take in place in such a way that the information is transferred from the cell body to the axon terminal, or reverse. So the information going away from the cell body is called as the anterograde transport, whereas the information moving towards the cell body is called as the retrograde transport. So friends, this was the detailed structure of a neuron, in which every part of the neuron has been explained. It must be noted that the space between two nodes of Ranvier is called as the internode.